So, hi everybody. We are starting Midnight Loft Online. It's conversation of musicians. And we are having here a discussion about artistic lifestyle, life hacks, hobbies, and many, many, many more other interesting themes. And so tonight, here and now, we are having a great guest, Italian pianist Emanuele Rimoldi, who will join us in a few minutes. About Emanuele, I can say that he is participant of two my personal projects, projects of chamber music, Metro Concert Art, and Loft Philharmonic. So he took part in my project in 2017, and actually it was a stunning new because it was fantastic performance. And today we will speak with him about artistic experience and musical themes. So join us, it would be very great. Hello to everybody. So
ciao, ciao again, Alisa.
Ciao, ciao, Emanuele. Ciao.
No, how are you? After I speak 1 hour with you in Russian, now we begin the.
No, I mean I have no problem to speak with you in English now. It's even better, more comfortable.
Maybe it makes more comfortable. It's true, but unfortunately, it happened an accident because my phone. It's a very old phone, unfortunately, and it has this big minus of the battery, which is
just... So now you are having low battery.
Let's say that when it will be low battery, I will wear these things. So you will look at me like in the...
headphones. Like
in the space, yes.
Really giant headphones. Okay, but I think it would be enough for 1 hour.
I will be opening just the light. Because
so for the next time we will start from English part, okay?
Yes, yeah.
So. Probably it's the best solution for us.
Yeah, maybe. So. No, but it was a great pleasure to speak with you before, and I think also audience which are actually online and they can see, they understand mostly Russian. No, they are enjoying more probably than in English.
You know, this time I felt that it was a really joyful thing, and we were joking, you know, about something, because last time it was very serious online.
We are serious people.
Yes, and I think that you had upgraded somehow. No, really, because for the last time it was first online for you, and now you are having a habit and you feel more relaxed, because I'm doing every day, every night, I mean. So for me, no problem at all.
Yes, you have a variety of guests, which is like with your own projects. Now you are inviting. How many concerts you organize in these years? 3 years, 200 concerts. It's like crazy numbers. You are really super manager, really unbelievable producer.
Oh my God! Thank you very much. But it's near, of course, to 200, but a little bit less. Let's say honestly. But
huge
for
number.
Me, for me, it's really a pleasure to have all my artists, and because everybody are so different. And actually, about your experience during, for example, even my projects. Oh my God, they were so different, and you had a fantastic team with you in this chamber groups. And you had fantastic program because it was very interesting for the audience, and you had moderated your performance, and it was for the first time.
I remember that people were surprised that I speak Russian. No, I mean I said "Dobry vecher," and everybody clapped like I did something very special. Actually,
but it was of course a big difficulty for you because to speak, you know, more private in this, for example, dialogue in Russian is quite possible, let's say, and to speak for the big audience in Russian for you,
this is
quite
true.
Big stress.
And I had the fever that night. No, I was having temperature, so I was
You were too tired. Your mantra.
But perhaps I was just very stressed to speak, no? Not to play, but to speak. And so I got temperature just by it.
Strange, so but my projects, you know, are difficult, actually.
In Japan, I spoke to the public, but I spoke in English with translator, so it's a bit different.
So, actually, I have so many questions to you. my dear. You know, so many things are happening in our artistic world, and as I was saying before, everybody is so different. Let's start from the main question for me. Very, very difficult question, actually, about music.
Okay.
Because to understand who you are, it's possible from the one sentence. What is exactly music for you as an art?
As an art? Music an art. Is simply life, and art is also life, no? So is we are living a life of art. A life of artist, no? Also, I simply cannot imagine my life without art, as I consider that life cannot exist also without art. No, I understand of everybody. I mean, especially in this period of quarantine, everybody expects to see something very beautiful from which is missing, no, right now. So music is accompanying us, paintings is accompanying us, beautiful writing is accompanying us, our life to grow up ourselves as a human being, and is teaching us how to become better also for the community of people, no? So I think not only for me but for everybody is kind of the same, no? Mm-hmm. Don't you think?
Yes, I think like this also, but you know, I have a question to you. How do you think from the side of audience, do they have difficulties now without any performances, any concerts, nothing at all?
But you know, I was thinking about it today. You know, when you are meeting, for example, when let's imagine that I'm in another country, no? And I want to speak, and I speak by phone with my dog. My voice is the same, right?
Mm-hmm.
But my dog doesn't recognize me. He recognizes me from other things, no? Obviously. Dog doesn't recognize by voice of the telephone. It's not existing. Why? Because there is missing something. It's missing even the vibration, which is cutting by the... by the connection of the telephone, no? The sound is not the same. I'm not saying only the smell of, obviously, he cannot smell you by the phone, still. But I suppose that even in recordings, no? So you listen to a CD or a LP, even LP, it doesn't have all the same vibrations of a real yes. concert in the real hall. And I think this is essential because live music, it is making vibrations inside the body of the people. And is everybody wants to get a concert, can be a good concert or a bad concert, but basically they come back with something home. Maybe they even don't notice. It's like to go, I don't know, in church, for example. You get some calmness, no? I remember, for example, before... every concert I was having in Moscow, I was always going to the church where Pushkin was marrying. Mm-hmm. Just for my calmness, not because I go to pray or something.
But it was on the way from the hostel to conservatory.
Exactly, exactly. No. But it's particularly beautiful one. And there, you know, you come back from it with completely different vibration. And then you can go to the concert and perform more calmly. So the same thing, I think it's for any audience, no?
Mm-hmm.
So I think that this is something that is missing the public. And it's, of course, maybe even somebody doesn't notice, but it's existing, this problem.
Yeah, the problem of connection, the problem of inspiration of public, because they are receiving nothing. They're receiving, by the way, zero, I think, because of this screen. So, of course, it's like hiding the main.
But look, even Deutsche Grammophon, let's say, the best label imaging poster with yes. best recorder, anyway, it's not the same.
Yes. But so does it mean that you have quite, not negative, but quite calm relation to online concerts? Or actually, this option is still possible for you?
Of course it's possible. Of course it's possible, because anyway, missing of something. I mean, even if I would do live concerts, I would never refuse to make a good recording. Let's imagine that, for example, completely opposite opinion than me, Glenn Gould. He was a fanatic of making recordings. He was seeing in the recording the art of record, how to make it perfect, the audio, etc. You know, then you see somebody else like Celi Vidache, which was saying that the recordings were absolutely ridiculous. Because how you can record each violin of the orchestra? No, you record only two violin, viola, cellos, and it's not enough, no? So our ears are much more developed than still microphones. And I'm open to live concerts, and I don't see nothing bad in it, even I see only good in it. Because anyway, for example, I think that recordings are helping our life very much. And also, life of a student, I mean, of music, like me. Mm-hmm. I'm studying music, no? So it's helping me to understand what is good and what is bad in music also, no? Mm-hmm. Or at least to get an essence of it, no?
Because, you know, this question had existed because I think that we are all in such, you know, suspicious situation that probably before it would be all opened, I think that we will receive some propositions about directly online concerts. So that's why I asked you. So we should be prepared for this option.
I'm prepared to play tomorrow for anything. You know, I mean, I am always ready.
Oh, it's very good that you are open-minded and you are prepared for this, because that the new beginning would be directly from this point.
I tell you the truth. I'm not so sure about. I don't agree with you, but it can be that you are right. So let's see.
Here in Russia, for example, here in Russia, in Moscow, we are having these discussions, by the way, also about my project, about Loft Philharmonic, that the first step to feel again in our life, let's say like this, it would be online concerts, which I hope so will start in August or in September. But of course, this is the most positive script of the situation. But anyway, this is something. Mm-hmm. So let's go deeper by our questions. Being an artist, this is actually a difficult also question. You should have some qualities inside, qualities, I mean, personal qualities and also professional qualities, and you should have a special musical experience. What can you say about directly connecting with yourself?
There are several type of qualities. I mean, you can categorize them in different sectors. So there is the quality which is necessary to get in the life better, no? How to say? To improve socially. I mean, that socially that you get from, for example, from hard worker in the beginning. For example, let's say a journalist, you write first of all a small newspaper, and then you became redactor of the New York Times, no? So to get this, you need some qualities, no? The qualities of ambitious, perhaps. And this, let's say the truth, this is quite common quality. But I think it's maybe necessary, because there are many people which are very talented and very, very good, and they are maybe not ambitious, they are maybe not very caring. So also,
so it's,
I think,
important to be ambitious.
But, you know, ambitious, but not aggressively ambitious, as I call it.
Not like
sometimes.
Russian ambitious, right?
No, I wasn't meaning directly Russian, but I don't want to categorize by country. I think just ambitious, essence of ambition should be a little bit, of course. So let's put this category. Then what is category of the human being? Human being, it's very important to keep in my opinion. Of course, we have plenty of examples of great musicians which were not particularly good person. It's full of examples. Unfortunately. But if you look, assume of all musicians, at the end, you notice that all great personalities in quite all spheres, not only music, they were also good persons. So I think
They're just very simple in the ordinary life. They are not...
Exactly. This is also one part. Simplicity is very important to develop, no? Simplicity is the main because it's so difficult to achieve, no? And so this is also, I think, one quality which is important. So to be good, could be good with others also. To develop the light which we are having inside ourselves, I think also is important, because music also is art, is light, no? We want to bring light to others. So how you can bring light if it's fake light, no? Instance. So
no, impossible, because the audience will never believe in such artists. Never.
Exactly. So of course there is somebody who were not very particularly pleasant person, but inside themselves they always find this light, no? So this is important to find. And then third is to develop perhaps in another category the musical qualities, no?
Mm-hmm. Art and, is light, I love it. Ah, hi Jonathan, it's very nice that you joined us. Today we are having it online in English. So you will finally understand. This is my American friend.
Ah, really? Okay, fantastic. Yeah. So, yes, for the first time probably you will understand because, so with my Italian accent. So, and so we were saying that the musical point of view from artists who develop also musically, I think also this, for example, sense of silence, sense of hearing. So, for example, how to hear not only where you are playing, but to develop the hearing in a big hall also, for example.
Is it important to have, strong character, really, to be a fighter inside the music? Or it's not so important, in your opinion?
No, fighter you can be for emerging the social world. I mean, to don't give up. I think this is unfortunately happening to everybody, that life is very hard sometimes, and you have not to fight against, but to accept and stand up again and try.
No, but probably I was meaning in difficult situations for musicians. I was meaning competitions or some other events where you should, really show your character. And show it as much as possible, actually.
Well, competition is a part world, so let's not discuss horrible things like this. But, for example, to develop character. What is character? Sorry. Character is what you have behind your ideas, right? So...
Uh-oh.
Which is saying that it's 20%.
Uh-oh.
So,
yes.
No, it's no problem. And I think that, for example, when you play, you should know what you are playing, no? So why you play this piece? What you want to say playing this piece? And this is the main thing which should pass to the audience. And not only to the audience, but to yourself. Because if you are not honest to yourself, also you will be never feel very good, no? So the main thing, it is character. I mean, of course, how to say, if you are a very weak person, so of course you cannot have the power to be an artist, obviously. But the main thing is brain behind and heart, no? Big heart,
yes, of course.
And big brain.
But but in the Russian version, we were touching one thing, very interesting, self-confidence. And you were saying about... ego inside every artist, and so you are taking it really serious, and you you explained why you think like this. Can you also say several words about me?
Yes, we were talking about this anecdote, which I find it very, very impressive for me, because I met many teachers in my life, and perhaps I can include among my piano teachers this Bonzo, which I met in Japan. I was a monk, practically. So I was in this beautiful temple, and I was asking this Bonzo how to read a Zen garden. How is reading? Because actually I always saw many Zen garden, but I don't know exactly how to read, And he asked, first of all, how do you see yourself when you play? Where are you when you play the piano? And my answer, it was between here and here. Well, no, it's not in the camera. So between here and here. No? So not where I am now, no? So, but not also there, up. In between. So in a, let's say, in a region in which everything can happen, perhaps, no? It's everything possible. Probably this, it's also have an explanation in physics, no? Quantistic physics. Probably some scientists can find some relation of this place, no? And because physics, has, by the way, it has many connections with music and with life. So, and by the way, with Oriental philosophies as well. And
but on the physical...
no, physics, yeah. Yes. Yeah.
So sound, like from physics also.
Yes, yeah, sound, but the idea of time, for example. The idea of time also is completely related to the quantistic physics. And I think it is useful to study something about, to understand also the idea of acoustic. For example, the time we are playing right now in the performance on the piano, it's not the same time a listener hears at the end of the chord. So it's different. So you have to enlarge everything or to make faster.
Yes, and difficulty for every musician is to combine two different types of how you are hearing yourself from inside.
Yeah. And
from
this is the instrument we have.
Yeah, from the corner of the stage, for example, and on the last row of the hall.
Exactly. So, and he told me that the main thing, so this bones again, he told that... we are all having a big fight with ego, and the idea of concentration it is to arrive to put out the ego of ourselves. So now, as a musician, you, I, all, we are having big ego, and we are need this ego for being able to go on the stage and don't be scary, exactly. And but some musician is still very scary. I remember Horowitz was very scary to go on the stage. Apparently, Marta Argerich is scary to go on the stage. So,
but what about you? I mean, so when you are coming on the stage, do you feel comfortable or you feel nervous about?
In the past, I was afraid. Now I feel more comfortable than anything else.
Even I can say also about myself that I feel agitated, of course, somehow. Mm-hmm. Impossible to stay calm completely. But anyway, with years, I think that I have this habit to go on the stage and to don't feel, you know, absolutely stranger on it.
This is very good quality, I think. And it's lucky that you are having, because otherwise you would suffer every time you go on stage, no? Yeah. So consider yourself very lucky. And I consider myself very lucky, too. And... I think that this monk was absolutely right. To fight the ego anyway. So what it remains? At the end, I arrived to the conclusion that remains the... He was saying the nature in the relation of the Zen garden. But I think maybe the love. So the music which you are playing, to begin to concentrate on each small detail of it, love it. And perhaps... in this moment, you forget about yourself, even, no? And you begin to create a real relation with the public, which before you were creating anyway with ego. Everybody tries to look at you, concentrate on you. Now you are not anymore. You are somehow conquering them, somehow, mm-hmm. by seduction, somehow, no? So I think it is important also this aspect for a musician to develop own way and to put a part of the ego.
Oh my God, Emmanuel, honestly speaking, you're so poetical. You're so romantic.
It's evening. It's late evening.
Yeah, this is... Wow, my God, such a story, really. Well, okay, so and about some other activities of your life, I want also to know some details. Tell me, please, about your experience of teaching, and especially I'm interested in your master classes, because, as I know, you are teaching to children all over the world, in Italy, in Japan. Tell me about this experience.
Oh, you said half wrong, half true. I mean, I teach to first of all, around the world. I teach master classes in Italy and in Japan. I gave master classes and in Russia as well. So, and but not only to children. I had some children also. For example, last time in Japan. Yeah, all ages. I think they arrive until 6 years old. Who did the masterclass last time in Japan? They were having all ages. Mm-hmm. So some professional pianists, some less professional, some with ambitions to be professional. And I think the better the student play, better I can help, sincerely speaking, because I really can give suggestions which... You know, it's easy for me to teach because I had very good teachers. So for me, even just to repeat what it was said to me, it will already help. Then additionally, I think that each student needs own language, no? Because each student is different. Each student has different speed. Each student has different... talent somehow, no, but in a different way. And so this is perhaps something that it should be taken in care. But personally, I don't consider myself a teacher. And I do these masterclasses time to time. I mean, once per year, perhaps. And I do it with great pleasure. But mm-hmm. This is not my life as a common.
Okay. You advised me. I will do several questions about your main part of your life. I know that solo piano.
I thought bringing the dog outside. I see.
No. Of course, you are a very good pianist, and you know, I want to do a structure of your study, because I met you when you were studying in Moscow State Conservatory. But as I know, before you had already graduated from Milano State Conservatory, and also you had some classes, I don't know how to call it correctly, in Germany.
In Imola
mm-hmm. Academy, I remember. So you had so many teachers, and you had so many different lifestyles somehow. So tell me about all your experience. What was the main, what was the most bright in all your musical experience during this time?
Hey, it's a big question, because as you say, I had many teachers and I had many many experiences. You know, the point is that when you are very young, and my family is not of musicians, so you don't know exactly where to go, to who to go, and what is the right
way. Situation. Yes, I completely understand you.
Yes, right. So it's very difficult to find the right person immediately. But somehow, I tell you the truth, I was quite lucky somehow that I found some teacher with some talent which gave me some good suggestions. Some teachers with, which, let's say, a little bit less, gave me wrong suggestions, but it was also useful because, as I say, always it's important to know how to play also, but not how, also how not to play, you know? It's very important. And I had many masterclasses as well. So we are talking about more than 20 teachers. But my main teachers, of course, is Moscow. Mm-hmm. Because
so
anyway,
of course, Versaladze is taking very honorable place.
High place, and her assistant as well, because... I was studying, let's say, with her, but I remember she was saying to me, come to study with me in Munich or in Moscow. And she said, but of course, Moscow is better because not only I have assistants, but there is a cultural life which is not possible to paragonate with Munich, obviously. And I of course, chose Munich. And I went to Munich 1 year. And of course, I did immediately. I switched to Moscow then. And it was fantastic experience, 5 years. But I met not only her, fantastic. For example, I personally have a fantastic relation, personal relation, musical relation with Dina Joffe. With her, I feel that we are really having something in common. Every time I had a lesson with her, I was feeling very, very near to her vision of music. But Versaladze also. But I had lessons with, I remember one time with, for speaking about masterclasses, about with Ashkenazi, Vladimir Ashkenazi, which told me a few words, but these words were very useful. Just a few words, but you know how he said these words, that it was making me... I saw one interview of him. He was saying that he was very happy that Richter made a masterclass to him. And he said just a few words. And he was very happy. And he did the same to me. And I in that moment, I was not understanding, but I was inspired. And then he hugged me and everything is finished like this. So, and for example, with Ivo Pogorelic, it was a completely different lesson. Ivo Pogorelic took me more than 3 hours perhaps on one piece, and we worked heavily to find the center of the sound of one note, just maybe for 1 hour and a half.
Yes, you told me.
Yes, so, you know, I'm not saying that I agree with generally with one pianist or with another. Everybody plays how he feels is correct. Not necessarily what Pogorelic or what Ashkenazi told me, I follow. But it is entering inside me. And I think each student, which has a possibility of piano, no, should develop this multiculturalism, multiculture, no? Of meeting other teachers, other experiences, and life experience as well, no?
Yes, but it's somehow it's difficult then to crystallize the sense of all your experience, because it's so big material somehow.
Yes, so important is to have very big self-confidence also, because otherwise you can be like a leaf which flies in the wind. Of course, you are right. Also, the Russian method to have, for example, one teacher in Semsha, in the Central Musical School, one teacher in the Moscow Conservatory. Also, it's a very strong method, mm-hmm. if you are lucky to have a good teacher. Because not in Moscow, it's not that everybody is good.
It's also true, but I think that so many are still, thank God, good, that it's possible
absolutely,
to find...
Absolutely,
absolutely. Yes, but they all have the same problem, if I can say like this.
Sorry?
All professors have mm-hmm. something in common. They really have one big problem, if I can say like this, because they are having very strong characters, which are absolutely sometimes not acceptable when you are studying under them. It's also possible that in Moscow you can notice this easily. Mm-hmm. Is it true? How do you think?
You know, I know several of them. I met with many, but... during my studies with Virsaladze, I was just very studying just with her and with her assistant. And I was not following. In that moment, I was not feeling that I need to follow other voices. And then, after I finished to study with her, I had some lessons with Dina Joffe, for example, and with another teacher also. And then I understood that I have to follow my own vision. Mm-hmm. That perhaps the best teacher you can have is yourself. Once you learn everything, how to say, mm-hmm. you can never stop to learn. I can go to Virsaladze for all my life, no? But
yes, of course. But no, sometimes you need help of somebody, and then you're finding finally your thought.
Important is structure. You are right. You were saying before about structure. Also, is important. For example. I had a bad experience about it, that one teacher in Imola was trying to change completely my structure. Mm-hmm. And he was saying, you have completely to change the way to play. Obviously, this it was a big mistake from him, because to change completely is wrong already, you know. You have to adapt yourself to the student. But, you know, it can happen. But, for example, in Moscow, I found... really what it was missing to me means a very strong school behind. And I think it was unprescindible. Yeah, very important for me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, actually, I was thinking that you are a person who develop yourself with different styles, and you are taking care about other arts, about your, I don't know, lifestyle generally, you're doing Tai Chi, so you're developing in many, many, many spheres. And actually, I was impressed when I found out one day that you're getting on with very interesting persons like Bruno Mansonjon. And I would like that you will divide and share with this story with the audience, if it's possible.
About Bruno Mansonjon?
Yes.
No, well, I had the lucky that, you know, I once it happened very strange thing that I was
because you know Emmanuel, he's completely legend, and for us it's so wow.
Yes, yeah, I understand he's legend. Yes, of course. You know, it's the funny story because actually, well, I met him first of all in a masterclass, by the way, where it was Virzaladze, and he was there to make a seminary. And somehow we spoke, I was speaking Russian with him, and he told me that I speak with very, very good Russian, almost without accent. And said by him, you know, he also, no, but you know, he speaks Russian perfectly, in fact. So, then we didn't get on anymore, but one night, it was in 2014 or 15. I dreamed about him. It happens to me sometimes. For example, one time I dreamed that I did lesson with Glenn Gould. And Glenn Gould told me very interesting thing. He told me about the third sonata of Scriabin, for example, that I was, if I want to play, I have to play more slow in tempo and not how I'm doing Dionysistic way, how I'm playing it. And then I was very curious to listen his recording because he recorded this sonata. And actually in the recording, which I didn't know, he was directly playing as he told me in the dream. In the dream was better, I have to tell you the truth. But anyway, it was exactly in the same style. So actually somehow I consider that I did a lesson with Glenn Gould. And I did also one lesson with Rachmaninoff another time, but I forgot it completely. So I dreamed about Mansonjon. You know, incredible coincidence, I wrote to him an email because I had his contact somewhere. And he called me. And he told me, you know, you cannot believe I am in Moscow now. What a coincidence, no? And I remember I was in Apshizhitye, in the dormitory, and I was very surprised about it. And then somehow we got in contact. He was, he's a very pleasant person, probably very curious person to meet young musicians also. Then he heard my performances, and he liked very much. Even he passed my recording to an artist director in France. And, you know, he wrote about me.
But didn't he want to be a director of another movie about you?
But you know, sorry. Okay, first of all, I would never ask something like this to him. But
it was his proposition because he found out that you are a brilliant pianist.
You know, to make a movie, I know already from my friend, which makes movie, short movies. No, and I know he makes publicity. You know, how much does it cost to make a movie? It's a billionaire business, you know. For the site to make a movie about somebody, unless I have a sponsor which does this, I don't think it would be such easy task to ask or to do. But however, let's come back. So I began to develop this contact, and last time I met, it was maybe 1 year ago, he presented his new documentary about Rostropovich. A beautiful movie about Rostropovich. He called me and told me, you know, tomorrow I'm going to present the movie about in the conservatory. Come to see. And I went. It's very beautiful, very touching, really movie. Short, quite. And I was one of the few who understood because it's in French and in Russian. So Italians were a little bit in shock. Oh, some Italian speaks French, of course, among the cultural people.
But probably we should explain to the audience that actually you know also a bit French, right? A bit Romanian, a bit Russian, English, Italian. So five languages in a row, right?
But I speak everything very bad.
No. Just
no, okay, doesn't matter. So, and by the way, he speaks better than me by far. And he speaks also Italian very well. And then the day after, we went to a Chinese restaurant, and we spoke about many interesting things. I was very curious to know about his the story behind his documentaries, and of course there are many anecdotes. For example, about Glenn Gould, how he was recording one part of the Prelude and Fuga of Bach, and the Prelude, it was made with one piano, and the Fuga with another piano, because he sold the piano, because he was thinking in the Prelude that he found the ideal instrument for himself. And then after a while, he decided this is so bad piano, and he changed it. So you see that is quite interesting, I think, to in each sphere of the... He is with music, but if you meet somebody who is really great in something, it's always interesting to meet and in each sphere, no?
Okay. Just I was very curious, sorry for this question, but really.
No, of course there are many anecdotes about, but okay, let's not.
So great. Yes, let's touch another type of theme. For example, I will again remind you about your fantasy on the themes of Rimsky-Korsakov. It's your new piece, and we are waiting for your premiere.
I repeat, let's see. No, really, because how to say?
This is your hidden talent, another one type of talent.
No. To be a composer, of course, is very nice, and for me, it's also
okay. Not
very...
composer, but transcriptor, probably.
No, or because transcriptor is another thing. No, transcriptor, it is to take the music of Rimsky-Korsakov and to transpose it for piano. I'm doing a paraphrase, kind of a fantasy, so I'm using some of his theme, but I'm changing. I'm using also my own music, trying to use some of his harmonies, I mean, which mostly he used in this...
By the way, we didn't announce about what we're speaking. Golden Cox, right?
Crococel, I think, in English.
Golden Crococel by Rimsky-Korsakov. Mm-hmm. By
Rimsky-Korsakov. Yeah, Zolotoy Petrushchok. So Golden Crococel, I think it's correct to say. So I tried to follow his idea of harmonies, and the main task there, it is to be able to transfer to the piano this atmosphere of magic which has Rimsky-Korsakov always, no, in his operas. Which are always so magic and from another world always. So, for example, in all his opera, Golden Crococel, Kitesh, or Tsarskaya Nevesta, by the way, also. And Snieguroczka, yes.
Satko,
for example, Satko. You go under the ocean, you know? So this is, you know, all his operas are magic. And it's important to transfer this magic atmosphere in the piano. So this is my main task. And of course, to make the clap at the end, also my other main task.
So
to be able to
you,
make it...
So you work hard, not exactly as a composer or pianist or transcriptor, but you're working like a wizard.
A wizard. No, but this is I think a funny job, no? Actually, you know, the good point of composing is that I don't have to practice.
Well, this is a joke, of course, but
it's
you're
a joke
preparing...
because I'm composing too difficult for piano always.
don't be shy and say tell us honestly that you are preparing this special premiere and special piece for one recital. Or even not for one, but for nearest recital, which would be in the Japan, right?
Yes, in October. Hopefully, everything it will be good. So finally, after two cancellations of my trip to Japan, I will come back there with a different program than what I was planning in the previous tours.
By the way, the secret what you will play or you will announce?
No, it's no secret. I play all first half Chopin, second half my piece, and the picture of exhibition of Mussorgsky. So first half Chopin is quite balanced between different aspects of Chopin. I was saying you that the previous recital was based, you know, generally I like to base on some theme. So for example, the previous recital, it was based on the theme of Eros and Thanatos.
Yes,
so life and death. And I was using some music, for example, of Janacek sonata, no?
Oh,
and I was thinking,
sonata.
Yeah, beautiful, no? And this beautiful sonata, it was representing somehow the, you know, if I'm not wrong, Thanatos, brother or something like this, you know, in the mythology, was the god of sleep. I don't remember, brother of cousin or, you know, something like this in the mythology, Greek mythology. So I like to think about this sonata with the idea of sleep, no? Of sleep, death. It's also an interesting combination. And Greeks knew many things already. Eh? So and in the previous recital, I was combining the idea of mirror recital.
About reflection effect.
Reflection, exactly. So how what you can see in Preludes of Chopin inside the Eighth Sonata of Prokofiev and vice versa with some Mozart passing between. And,
you know, you are very many pianists because not every pianist thinks so much about the concept.
Concept, I think it's important to make pass people some idea. And not just not necessarily a concept which should be written in some name, no? For example, now we will do in October with Chopin, there is not a name on it, no? Unlike I want to call this recital the Golden Crocodile. So I think there is no theme there, but important it is balanced well, no? Not to put, you know, Campanella, Liebestraum, etc.
Yes, in this case it would be like, you know, like a masquerade.
Yes, of course.
I also don't understand such concepts because I even don't take it like a concept because it's impossible to understand.
You know, it's a problem of our society because there is the tendency of bringing the public more to our concerts, right? We want more public. So what we do, I mean, not me, what some artists and some artist director and manager
yes.
of the site
yes.
to
do
put
like
our
market.
Level
yes. Yes.
Work,
yes.
instead to bring up the public. So my decision is to make always things at my level and as I like. If this is not liked by somebody, is welcome to don't come, sincerely speaking. But I think that always it was successful, this idea to make people attracted by something which it's making them also on the level, no? I think people wants to feel something good. And I'm explaining in the notes, program notes, what is my thoughts about this music because I'm writing them sometimes, time to time. In Japan, I do this. And so this, I think it's also very useful to involve the public in what you're doing because maybe Eighth Sonata of Prokofiev is a bit hard to understand, no?
You know, I'm wondering when, for example, this scheme which you announced for Japan, for Japanese people, will finally work for Russian people, for Russian audience, because it's very interesting.
I think today.
No, I'm very correct what you're saying, because actually I'm thinking completely the same. I think that absolutely not acceptable that marketing and, I don't know, the logic of halls, they're really dictating somehow. And everybody playing the same pieces, the same concepts, the same concerts, and everything is quite the same. It's like twins.
But that's just, why...
Yes, just the names of artists are changing a bit.
But that's why you are a genius producer, because you made so fantastic projects, really, in Moscow. And it's a pity that you don't do in other places, too. I would like to see your projects in Europe or in America, if you have somebody who follows from America, or in Japan as well.
Well, would be my pleasure because actually to duplicate Loft Philharmonic and its experience, it would be fantastic.
If I get better connection in Japan, of course, I will one day help you if it's possible. It's with my possibility, you know, because, you know, really, I think that your projects are very creative and I think that Japanese would appreciate very much. Japanese are very creative people as well, you know. They love to see something something new and something beautiful.
I believe it. And by the way, we have also something in common with Japanese people because all projects supported by Yamaha.
yes, of course. I have sponsored by Yamaha, which I am very grateful for their support. But yes, of course, you are also connected with Yamaha. So.
Yes. So I was saying that probably one day in Russia will come such day that people also will understand all these concepts, and it would be very good. And by the way, answering you to your invitation, probably in the nearest future, let's believe, mm-hmm. I also want to welcome you to Russia again and to take part in my projects, which are still here. Yes, and you are always a really good guest at the Loft Philharmonic. With now, by the way, as you know, we're trying to develop all the time, develop, and we're having not only chamber series but also solo recitals. Oh, we have problem with connection, Emmanuel. Oh, we have problem with connection, right? But by the way, I think that 8 minutes left.
So I will put the other copies anyway.
Okay.
Wow,
but anyway, you are looking stylish. And I was saying that I hope that you will take part also in my project. For example, Loft Philharmonic, which has now, as you know, not only chamber music recitals, but also solo loft recital. And probably for you, it will be another type of experience, and you will really appreciate to take part in, I hope so.
With all my soul.
Oh.
No, seriously. No, it's also not only the pleasure to come back to Russia, which is a country which I love, where I studied, where I lived for many years, the occasion to meet many people, many friends, the occasion to maybe go again to theater, which I was loving to visit when I was in Russia, and the occasion to play for Russian public, which it was always very pleasant for me. Russian public is very friendly, you know. I always liked. So why not?
No, but you have this Italian charm. Of course, it's impossible to answer to your performance.
Okay. So, you know that I don't, я не ценую очень my Italian part. No, I don't consider so much this part of me.
Okay, so let's speak about your Armenian part in this case.
Yeah, I think it's a better part. Sorry. Unfortunately, half and half,
you know,
what can I do? Yeah.
But I will do a small surprise to you. I'm not dividing you part by part. I see you like a whole.
I'm a complex.
Complex, yes.
I see.
Okay. So, Emmanuel, I think that we are quite near to finish our...
Yes. So, today we spoke actually quite intensively, you know, about many subjects in Russian and in English. We are both a little bit tired, but it was really nice, really.
Yes, it was.
And
really
I thank
nice.
You so
I
much
took,
for.
I took so big fun actually, and thank you for this pleasure, because, you know, this video, of course, it's not like in life, but quite near, because I can see your face, your emotions. And by the way, I can say that you told about your friends in Moscow, and I want to say that really we miss you here. And
and next time I will do interview to you, Meta.
Okay.
With many interviews you are doing every day to many artists, nobody does interview to you. Don't you want an interview?
Actually, I had interview only once, yes, during all these 5 seasons of Midnight Loft Online.
I saw that you did very beautiful one, all right? No, in
for 2 hours, yes. I was doing for 2 hours, and I hope that this week, by the way, Cultural Center Zeal had invited me for interview. And yes, probably this week I will have official one, like from Loft Philharmonic producers. Speaking.
Fantastic. Yeah, because of course you are a producer also, not
But actually I want, and I will take part with pleasure if you will invite me, of course, anytime you want.
Yeah, I don't invite to me my Instagram, because as you know it's absolutely a zero. But we can do one evening like this, and where I do the questions and you are.
Okay, anyway, you can do it from your page, because when we will start to stream, everybody will see 2 pages which would do like this beeping. My audience will connect if they want, so no problem.
I see.
This is just technical things. And by the way, again, one in Russian, one in English, right?
Yes. Yes,
okay.
This is heavy task we did, really. But it was really pleasant.
So I think it was quite successful. Thank you for taking part in Midnight Loft Online.
No, thank you to you for the invitation. And do skoro.
Do skoro. Ciao, ciao, Emanuel. Ciao.
Ciao, ciao, ciao. Paka.
Have a good night. Bye, bye, bye.
Good night, good night.
Good night. So, actually, we had finished our Midnight Loft Online, and for today, in two languages, with charming and fantastic Italian pianist, half Italian, half Romanian pianist, okay, Emanuel Rimoldi. And by the way, you can find him in YouTube. He has so many interesting recordings, and you can follow him completely on Facebook, official page. I think that it would be very good because he is having so many interesting activities. And you can watch Midnight Loft Online for the next days. I think that the fifth season will finish on Saturday next week. So thank you for watching and bye, 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 guys. Have a good night. Sweet dreams.